Hey everybody, this is Vox and Sandra, and welcome back to LEGO Star Wars. So this time, we're on Kashyyyk with Yoda and Chewbacca, because that is in fact Chewbacca. I'm pretty sure it was in the movie too, even though there's no real reason for that to be Chewbacca, as opposed to just any other Wookiee. But yeah. So, Yoda, like I talked about it a little last time, Yoda moves really weirdly. He's got this weird, you know, this cane step, but in the original game, he had three modes of walking. He had this extremely slow. He does an extremely slow walk where with his cane. He could jump around kind of like this with his lightsaber. Like with his lightsaber out, he was constantly jumping around. And then if you tried to run without the lightsaber, he would pull. He would like had a hover chair. This one just sort of makes him make a little bit more sense. His cane walk is much more reasonable now. Also, as you might notice, he has a lot more reach with his attacks. Like he will jump further than most others on. Like that wasn't me. None of those were jump attacks. That was entirely just tapping the attack button. So Yoda's pretty nice like that. Once again, just making use of, or just trying to get all the studs we can. And yeah, at this point in the game, clone troopers are no longer our friends. How sad. I'm sure no one could have seen this coming. But yeah, Chewie. Chewie is a blaster character. He's blaster. Is a bit more powerful than normal, I think. Actually, I don't think it is. I think it's just a blaster. He has the usual grappling hook in it, though, which, you know, probably would have come in handy at some point, so. But he also has. No, I'm trying to melee him. Yeah, there you go. Remember how in episode 4 he's a, you know, Wookiees are known to rip people's arms out of the sockets? Yep. Keeps doing it. Also, that little pop-pop sound that I probably talked over is really good. I will definitely shut up at some point so that you can hear that pop-pop sound. But yeah, so right now we want to rescue our three Wookiee friends. We already got one. There's another one. And the last one's up here. Slightly weird, because in order to get it, we have to do this. Alright, Yoda, yeah, he needs to pull out the grappling hook, point. And then, Chewie. Oop. Oh, it's such a good sound. I'm sorry about beating up the Wookiee so much, though. I definitely don't mean to. That's, targeting can be a little weird sometimes. And yeah, you don't have to force those on, you can just shoot them on and then destroy them. Again, we could get more studs, but I'm trying not to grind too much. But yeah, with five of us, we can lower the drawbridge and get to something that was never in the movies, but would probably have been a fairly cool little set piece. As soon as, yep. Clones and droids fighting together. Never happened in the series. As soon as, they don't, yeah, and yes, those can kill you, but they don't make it completely clear in the, movie, but, supplemental material makes it clear that basically as soon as, Sidious, declared himself emperor, he basically sent the order for the droid army to shut itself down. Because there was nothing suspicious about that. Yeah. Sadly, you cannot rip droids' arms out of their sockets, because that's slightly different. Also, these guys are going to spawn infinitely. They will never stop. So, it's probably better to just come back here later when you're a little bit more powerful. And by more powerful, I mean when you are cheating. There's some stuff you have to do, but none of it's too bad. Fast Force gives us, lets us do that super quick. And we pop this guy off. Also, say hello to the only snail tank in the game. That one burning, that's the only time that they appear, those tank droids. Which is a shame, I kind of like those guys. But, you know, there's already enough stuff. There's an arc fighter that's sinking into the swamp. That's vaguely interesting and slightly foreshadowy. But so yeah, once again, we have a droid commander who is calling in reinforcements. So I'm trying to get a bead on him. But really, I should just take the do the simpler thing of just climb up here, which I'm pretty sure I'm about to do as Yoda. Yep. Yeah, so because Yoda can just jump up there. And of course, just grab that. And the other one's over here. I don't even think there's actually, you don't even, it's not like that even unlocks the next path. Like, I think you could keep going and just not even care. Also, like I had three, I spawned three hearts and then died. Oh well. So there's plenty of studs here, plenty of stuff to force and all that, but once again, just not trying to overuse any of that. You can use the force to pull the arc fighter up, but it is and you probably saw the minikit up there, but you need a high jump character to get that. Also, coming up here, we could just see one of the few things in this game that I think LEGO Star Wars, that the complete edition changed for the worse. Because in LEGO Star Wars 2, they gave you the ability to go into vehicles. And that's kind of cool. But it also allows enemies to go into vehicles. So in the original game, in the original version of this, this guy was just a normal enemy. Like, you would hit him and then he would die. Now he's a guy in a vehicle, which means that first of all, you've gotta hit him, although you can also force him out. At least I think you can force him out. And then he pops out, you gotta kill him again. The thing is, this is still here. So if another clone decides he wants to use it, you can't stop them. And I think that's a little bit of a problem that can, because it basically means, as soon as they do that, they immediately basically gain 4 HP and a bigger gun. So, I don't like that bit. I think it's, I don't know. I feel like I'll explain stuff later because I've already have. Time paradoxes! Also, rolling boulders that you can just shoot into pieces. And up here, we got another mini-kit. We have only two. We're already pretty close to the end of this level. But yeah, so, and then we're going to need to force this. Unfortunately, well, the boulders were coming, but they're not particularly fast. And yeah, you can force them to pieces. Alright, and now we got another one of those scout walkers, or whatever they're called. I forget what these versions are. I think these are like ATPTs. It's all-terrain personal transports. But, either way. Alright, so now we've got to blow up a bunch of stormtroopers. Stormtroopers? Clone troopers. I don't know, I would call them stormtroopers. That's not a thing. But anyways, yeah. So, you turn all these lights on, and then you destroy these things. Why do you have to turn them on and then destroy them? I don't know. It's a puzzle. Hit these, and then that opens this up. And once we get rid of these drones, they kind of are drones, but these clones, we can get these up, and if they don't shoot us, and boom, that's it. Yoda's going to just, well, he's still got a little bit to do, but not much. But that will be the end of this episode. So, thank you for watching. As we have unlocked Chewbacca. Also got our... not even close to True Jedi. Less than halfway there. And the minikit. Two pieces of it. Ah, well. But anyways, that'll be it for this episode. Thank you all for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will see you guys for the next time.